on a personal note, the first reading from Isaiah, I read and reread the first line over and over again this week. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. The time when we're all groaning from the issues and the problems going on, to know that God is there saying to us, comfort, give comfort to my people. He's not talking about taking away everything. He's talking about giving us comfort. And I think that is very important to us. On the internet, I saw a cartoon, and I may have said this once before. And the first panel has a sentence. Let's eat, Grandpa. Well, I found that rather threatening. The second panel puts in a comma. Let's eat, Grandpa. I found that more encouraging. And then the last panel says, punctuation saves lives. Now, the reason why I bring that up is in the ancient Hebrew, and even Hebrew today, it's very difficult to read. First of all, there's no vowels. Second of all, there's no punctuation. So Isaiah says to us, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. And in the Gospel of Mark, so that Mark could set up the story of John the Baptist, he says, a voice crying out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. You see the difference? Isaiah says, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. And Mark says, a voice cries out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Now I'm bringing this up because you understand that the Messiah was awaited for a long, long time. Right from the fall of Adam, when God said to the serpent, that I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head as you strike at his heel. That goes back to Genesis, that God was promising us through Mary to send us a Savior. So the Jewish people have been waiting thousands and thousands of years for a Messiah, groaning for a Messiah. And even devout Jews today are still waiting for a Messiah. Think about it. We've been dealing with this pandemic for about a year, and we're groaning and waiting for a vaccine to come to save us from this pandemic. Can you imagine waiting thousands of years for a Savior to come? So John the Baptist is telling the Messiah is coming, one mightier than me, whose thong I'm not even worthy to untie his shoe. He's coming. But let's go back to Isaiah. Isaiah is talking about repentance. And John is talking about repentance. What does that word mean, repentance? Well, its derivation actually comes to rethink. Rethink what's going on in your life. Are you preparing for the coming of the Lord? Isaiah says, go out into the desert and prepare for the Lord. We're waiting for Christmas, that's true, to celebrate the anniversary of the incarnation of Jesus physically coming into this world, God made man. What a wonderful celebration that always is. We also have to keep in mind that we're waiting for the coming of Jesus the second time. And are you ready? We asked that question last week. And the week before, we told you how to get ready. by giving us in Matthew the only place in the Gospels that talks about what judgment day will be. When I was hungry, you gave me to eat. When I was thirsty, you gave me to drink. When I was in need, you helped me. And the righteous says, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or in need and help you? And the king will say, as long as you did for the least, you did for me. So now we have to think, rethink. Are we preparing for the coming of Jesus? And so I like the Isaiah translation better. Go out into the desert. Well, where's your desert? Maybe it's a special place in your house, maybe in your car, maybe just in your own mind. Some people like to meditate and pray. So go into that desert and pray and prepare and rethink. Are you ready? John is offering a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. We think of sins as being this horrible mark on our soul. But remember, God said to us, I will be your God and you will be my people. So it's the times when we are not acting as his people that we need to ask for forgiveness. It's time to rethink what we've been doing. It's time to prepare for the coming of Jesus. Yes, at Christmas, and also for the second coming, which can happen, as Jesus said, like a thief in the night. You know not the time or the hour when he comes. So repent. Repent and get ready.